Ladies and gentlemen, this is Mampolo from Mampolo's Corner. Renew your mindset. I do tell most of my friends that in Nigeria, you might be very up there today, and tomorrow you are down. In Nigeria, today you might be a billionaire, and tomorrow you are begging on the street. Is that fast and simple? Today, they might be hearing your name everywhere, and the next day you are a poor man. Nobody knows you anymore. Why did I just say so? Watch this video.
Finally, from the look of things, you can see that the whole thing is ending up here. This building is almost down, and you can see that the whole of this place, probably people went out to do their business, and you can see what is going on. It's definitely rendering this four-story building. You look at this. Can you see this? Can you see this? This is exactly what is going on here in Anambra State. An Hausa Fulani tanker driver has condemned buildings. This is Tony reporting for BTV. Here is Anambra State. An Hausa Fulani tanker has condemned the lives of millions and properties. Can you see this? There is no fighters that can protect this. Here in this place, no fire. This is properties. This is property, properties, millions of properties being burned down by the singular act. What can these people standing here do? Nothing. Millions of businesses are being burned. This place is motor parks. It is all completely gone. Can you see this building? There are so many people in this building now that we don't know if they have been able to evacuate them. Can you see this? The whole of this place. This is the kind of government we experience. No fire service is in Anambra State. No single fire service. None of them has shown up since this incident. Can you see this? Both bank, both business premises. It is all gone. There is none. Can you see this? The whole of this building is down. 100% down. It's down. Do you see it? This is a business apartment. This is Tony reporting for BTV. Here is Anambra State. All this building is full of business. This is where our people hold their business. And you can see how they all is a forgotten issue. This is a forgotten issue. In this state, there is no fire service that can come up to rescue this situation. No single fire service that can rescue this situation. No one. It is just started with just a tanker driver that fell down. But you can see what he's putting people, what he's doing right now. Can you see this? This is the experience we are having here in Anambra State. This is an ugly situation that is affecting millions of people. All people can do is to throw such a of pure water. What can pure water do in a situation like this? What can pure water do in a situation like this? What can people do? They are incapacitated. They are destroyed. They don't have anything. Do you see that? Please join me as I'm bringing this update to you. We all are just standing doing nothing because there is nothing we can do. This is the job of the fire. This is the job of the fire service men in Anambra State. Obiano said it's working. Obiano says it's working. What is happening? Does it mean they've not seen this? Since morning, does it mean they've not seen this? This is the experience people are having here. Very, very poor experience. Very, very poor experience. What can the Anambra do when they don't show any regard to what they are doing? I want you to know that this is the hope of the hopeless people in Anambra State. Since morning, it started with a tanker driver, but today, almost 10 buildings and properties worth of millions of
You see the video? Those are people's investment. Now, people get those investments to not be animals. These are millions going down. And the government has no power to even quench the fire. You see, so what about the people that their sole investment is there now? What do you think will happen to them in the next morning? You think they are still very rich, yeah? What of the people that have those buildings and these are all the investment put in there in that building? So what do you think will happen to them? Tomorrow they are down. That is lots of uncertainty in that country. It is not a country for self-business. It is not a country for self-properties. It is not a country for even self-human beings. It is not a country that people are even safe. So that's the problem. So most people who are investing there, they invest in fear. They know today, but they don't know tomorrow. They know this hour, they don't know the next 2 hours. That's the problem. Look at a whole long building burning down. No common fire service in the whole state to come and rescue them. Things are going down. People's properties are going down. People's wealth are going down. People's sweats are going down. You know, in a twinkle of an eye. Will that happen anywhere in the world? In this part of the world, before you see small smoke, somebody just smoked cigar, junkie just smoked cigar, throw them. Before you, that's as that smoke, they just come out, small. You don't hear, whoa. You go to say that they even go quench any reasonable thing. If you reach that place, now cigar, when they inside bin, neither go quench. Cigar, when they smoke, remain. Neither they do that siren everywhere, they run up and down, make them go quench cigar when they inside those bin. But for Nigeria, buildings go down, it go down to 12 buildings when they down. Na pure water than the stone. May that take quench fire. Ah, this country, they make me laugh. Una they say, oh no. That the stone pure water to quench fire. I know they understand what they happen there. Where are the Anambra Fire Service? They're not there. Where then they? And there are some people collecting money and salary that they are working in fire service. Because I know that. People are on a payroll who are working in fire service. So where are their services? The Nigerian annual budget covers fire service in Nigeria. Go and find out. The annual budget covers fire service. So where is the budget gone to? No, what is the use for that budget allocation for fire service? What is the use? This is not peculiar to only Anambra. It's everywhere in Nigeria. If this is happening in Lagos, the same response is what you're going to see. In Kano, the same response is what you're going to see everywhere in Nigeria. So it's just like that. So when you have a property and fire gets into it, you are finished. If you have a shop and a business, fire enters, you are finished. The business is finished, your life is shattered. So that's why I said, in Nigeria, it's not a safe haven for business to strive. It's not a safe haven for properties. It's not a safe haven for even human beings. So there's lots of uncertainties there. Anything can happen at any time. And you don't know when. It just be like the coming of Jesus Christ. It don't finish. Your business is like coming of Jesus Christ. Your property is like coming of like Jesus Christ. Even your life is like the coming of Jesus Christ. You don't know where you go move. I want to beg the governor of Anambra State, Governor Willie Obiano, not be being him. I beg, sir, no verse. Those people, when their property they burn, their businesses they burn, don't forget to do something about them. Don't forget. Most of them are their only investment you see there. So I beg, as you know, if you provide fire service, make them try rebuild their business or their properties for them. I hope lives we are not lost in the process anyway. Guys, if you love what I'm doing here, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Follow me on Facebook and Instagram. All about Polo's Corner. I love you guys. Peace out.